In psychology, emotion is often defined as a complex state of feeling that results in physical and physiological changes that influence thought and behavior. Physiological arousal expresses behaviors and conscious experience. In neuroscience, emotions are created as a result of charged neurohormones being released by the thalamus after receiving direct or indirect information from our natural senses. As a leader, we must understand which emotion can impact most on our leadership competence. The most important point about emotion is they are initiated outside our conscious control. They just happen. There's nothing we can do to stop that. They grab attention and they want to direct us. They can trigger feelings, behaviors, and actions. In essence, they are motivational drivers which want to guide our action in the short, medium, and long term. Fear is the most important and destructive emotion for a leader to understand. In today's world, fear is more insidious. It stops us wanting to change. We fear what we might have to let go of, who we might become, what others will think about us, and how we will be judged or criticized. It is the main emotion that stops us wanting to change ourselves or stick to our principles. Fear will prevent us from setting any intent that is likely to take us out of our comfort zone. The second most important negative emotion, which most of us experience frequently, is anger, which can range from little annoyances to major events. How we can manage our anger can seriously impact our own performance. But most importantly, as a leader, our anger can have a major impact on the performance of the people around us. One of the most common strategies we use to manage emotion is to try to hide them or ignore them. It does not work. While you may feel you are controlling your emotions, it will be impacting your behavior or your mood, and people will notice, and most likely they will imagine it is because of them, and that will distract them from their work, their engagement, and their productivity. It is vital that we acknowledge our emotions, understand them, and even embrace them. Then we can treat them as a friend and ally and use the information they provide in a positive way to determine our behaviors. The essence of managing our emotions effectively is to make sure they don't hijack us, so that we don't behave in a way that in hindsight we would have preferred not to. We all do it, but let's see how we can minimize it. First of all, we need to understand the timeline for managing our emotions. One perspective is that our emotions last 90 seconds from the initial trigger to total dissipation of the chemicals from the bloodstream. So, if our emotions are lasting longer, it is because we are subconsciously holding these circuits open. If we are aware of this, then we can learn to let them pass. Secondly, we must understand the neuroscience behind it. to be able to manage it. Although the brain is incredibly complex and the various parts of the brain are all interconnected, let me share a simplified version of what we need to know regarding how to manage emotions. The amygdala is the center for emotions, emotional behavior, and motivations. Its role is concerned with the perception of fear and preparing for emergency even. Its default reaction to a stimulus is fight, flight, or freeze. The prefrontal cortex is a part of the brain located behind the forehead at the front of the frontal lobe. It is responsible for a variety of complex activities, including thinking skills, planning, analytical processing, and rational decision making. The thalamus captures all the information from our senses and sends it to the PFC to process. It sends urgent information directly to the amygdala, bypassing the BFC, and as it is a shorter and quicker route, can explain the rapid reaction of a natural alarm system. Hence, information is sent to the amygdala in one of two ways. The short, quick, direct route creates an impression of the situation and generates an emotional response, fight, flight, or freeze. At the same time, the information is sent to the prefrontal cortex and is processed to form a more considered view as to what the response should be. Once the leader understands this, he can learn to manage and to make sure that except in a crisis or extreme danger, the short route does not control the process and his reaction to the situation. For this, the leader must work on understanding, learning, and practicing emotional intelligence.